Well, Memorial Day weekend is almost here, and it doesn't look like it right now, but there are some warm temperatures in the forecast. A lot of people will probably be out enjoying our local rivers and lakes.
Yeah, so today Jovi is in West Lynn with some important water safety tips from the Oregon State Marine Board. Good morning.
Yes, good morning, guys. Just enjoying a little early morning kayak session with Randy Henry. Randy oversees the boat safety program for the Oregon State Marine Board. So he's the guy who's basically in charge of making sure that we're all safe out there when we're on the water. And I should say, you know, he's not the one that's in charge. You're the one that's in charge, because really it's about making sure you take some pretty simple steps to stay out there in the water. Now, number one, Randy, as we were talking about you know, a few minutes ago, life jackets. So many deaths, unfortunately, last year we saw about 19 of them that might have been prevented if somebody had been wearing a life jacket. They were not when they had their, you know, boat capsized or when they fell off a paddleboard, whatever it might have been. So there's a number of programs and things in place so people can ensure that they have one on. For example, there are life jacket sharing stations. Right. Now, initially last year when COVID first hit, a lot of them were shut down, I guess, because, you know, we weren't sure about, is it sanitary? Is it safe? Can you be doing that sort of thing? You're telling me that they're back open now, and there's some new locations where people can, you know, make sure that they have a life jacket when they head out on the water.
Yeah, correct. If you do show up at the water and you don't have a life jacket with you, there are loaner stations at a number of locations. We've worked with the governor's office to determine that the benefit of having those life jackets on station outweighs any of the risk from contamination. So they're getting opened back up. They're generally managed by local parks districts or other folks. So they're able to open those up and they're available. If you get to a waterway and you or your kids need a life jacket, go ahead and use one of these.
Now, what are the regulations? For example, we're on kayaks. There's kayaks, there's stand-up paddleboards, there's, you know, motorboats, there's wakeboarding. There's all sorts of different things that people do out on the water. So what are the rules? And then what are the, I guess, suggestions for people? You know, because there's certain things that are enforceable and certain things that are, it's just not the people's personal responsibility.
Right. Yeah, there's best practices for sure. So the rules, in a boat like this, there are three things I need. I need to have a whistle, noise-making device.
Got it right here?
Yeah, got it right there. And then you need to have the life jacket. So the life jacket is really the most important piece of equipment in your boat. You also need, if the boat is over 10 feet or larger, you need a waterway access permit, which is something you can buy at your local Department of Fish and Wildlife fish licensing station or from the Marine Board. In a boat like this, that's what you need. Now, legally, I don't have to wear this, but it doesn't make a lot of sense not to. The water here is in the 50 degrees. It's going to sap your energy quickly. You really need to have, even if you're a good swimmer, even if you're fit, you need to have a life jacket on. It's kind of like saying you'd put your seatbelt, that you don't wear a seatbelt, but you'll put it on if you know you're going to be in a crash. Doesn't work that way.
There was a number you said, 50-50-50. What was that? You were telling me about that.
Yeah, there's an old adage in the boating safety world that a 50-year-old male would have a 50% chance of swimming 50 yards to shore in 50 degree water.
Yeah. And that's about how cold the water, I mean, the water's pretty cold right now.
Yeah. So if you're, and think about it, if you go in the water without a life jacket, you're going to be struggling to save yourself. If you're with other people, how are you going to help them?
Absolutely.
So especially for parents, wear the life jacket. Don't just make it something your kids wear. Wear your life jacket.
Absolutely. So we're going to have a lot more with Randy a little bit later in the show. There's also some new regulations that are going into effect this year that's going to, you know, regulate boating and certain things. We'll talk more about that a little bit later in the show. And we are going to try to stay upright. Hopefully we won't need the life jackets, guys. But, of course, we've got them on just in case. A lot more to come a little bit later in the show. Let's send it back to you in the studio.
All right, Joe. Thank you.